can I interest you in today? I hope it's to your liking. Here's what we agreed on. Ah, yes. I hope it's to your liking. I'll fetch a good price. Could never have too many.
Bloody cowards! Setting upon us after dark! I'd like to see them try again when the sun's high.
Man who saved Mummy. Thank you.
You haven't much, but you're free to look.
Quentin, my good man. It seems we'll be spending the night.
I thought as much. Where do you find that one?
Oh, him? You wouldn't believe me if I told you. Quinton here is an old friend, one who is sympathetic to our cause.
Sympathetic? And he knows about your little sanctuary. I would never have guessed so many people were bent on setting us free. When last I checked,
The mere thought would earn you a trip to the gallows.
I am well aware of the risks, as I am of the rewards.
And what could be more rewarding than your very own Dominant of Fire?
A Dominant? Here? Now that I would like to see.
Meaning you haven't?
No, but nothing passes unnoticed in Lostwing. Take your brand, for example. People will see that at once. And I need hardly tell you how they will greet the inquiries of a bearer. You are afraid your words will fall on deaf ears, as they have ever since the moment you were marked. Happily, I can provide a solution to your dilemma. As a favor to Sid, that is. Take this. You will find it has the uncanny power to loosen tongues. May the mothers guide you.
This might be Imperial land, but here in Lostwing, it's his word that's law.
But how?
You don't need to worry about that just yet. Trust me. Everyone in Lostwing knows what that seal means, and what it means if they don't take note. Now we can sit here counting our blessings, or put them to good use and find that dominance. Your choice.
Let's see if this thing really works.
That a hanged man, I see. Master Quentin must think you're important. It was a good thing you done today, getting rid of those bastards. If you hadn't come when you did, I'd be on my way to Ash by now. Along with the others. Poor buggers.
These others, was there a dominant among them? A dominant of fire?
Might have been, yeah. Royalists seem to think there was, anyhow. A thin bloke, all swallowed up in his robes like one of Great Grieger's churchmen.
Do you recall anything else about him?
Only that he weren't alone. Was a young maid who went wherever he did, including the church, and wherever the Royalists dragged them both off to before you got here.
I see. Thank you.
I'll tell you one thing for nothing. That girl with the hooded bloke weren't his missus. More like his pet blimmin' curl, ready to pounce.
Honored visitor, might I ask that you pray with us for the deliverance of our brothers and sisters from evil?
Nothing down here but dust and cobwebs.
Unless you're here to help me get rid of them.
That's all you can remember. Think hard.
Master Quinton has asked that we work through the night to undo the chaos the Royalists wreaked. But I fear dawn will have long since broken before the true damage is mended.
Oi, about some light over here. Black as Odin's bumhole.
What a mess.
What would the King of Ulud want with our tiny village anyway?
Ah. Master Quinton took a liking to you, I see. And there I was, thinking you were in bed with Sid. Wonder what Gav will have to say about this. Speaking of whom, if you see him, tell him thanks for looking after us. Now, what can I help you with?
I'm searching for a dominant of fire. Gav seems to think he might have taken refuge here.
We see a lot bearers around these parts. But I do seem to recall one who commanded the flame. Now, whether or not that makes him a dominant, I can't say. But the Waludas certainly took a keen interest in the poor sod.
Did you get a look at him?
Didn't have a chance. One of the other bearers might have, though.
Thank you. I wonder if Sid's found anything.
Bearers attuned to the element of fire are handy on the battlefield, as I'm sure you know. I expect that's why the Royalists wanted your men in particular.
Tell me that scowl means you've got good news. So, a shady lad with a hood, and his equally shady lass. Not much to go on, but...
But?
I've been thinking, if our friend is a dominant, why not just burn the Royalists to a crisp? There's a reason he's holding back, and I reckon he has something to do with his partner.
What makes you say that?
One of the villagers I talked to said the two were separated. If the Waludas have her, our dominants like to think twice before starting any fires. Whoever he is, he's shown himself to have a level head. He's careful, cunning, and he doesn't want to be found. This could spell trouble for us and the Royalists both. Still, it'll be a whole lot worse if we set off after them with bleary eyes and empty bellies. There should be a pair of pallets waiting for us back at the inn. Shall we? Now, about those beds.
Beds? I seem to recall your request being to spend the night. And for that, the floor will more than suffice.
Better than a wet rock, I suppose. My thanks, Quentin. Next time you're at the hideaway, our floor's all yours.
No need for thanks, Sid. This isn't an act of charity.
You don't say.
In exchange for my floor, I shall be requiring your services. The Royalists saw fit to erect a barricade across the road south when they occupied the village, and failed to remove it when they left. I expect it to be gone before you leave.
As you wish. Well, that took longer than expected. First time dismantling the barricade. It gets easier, don't worry.
I won't.
If we leave now, we'll arrive at the Caer when the shadows are at their deepest. Unless you'd rather wait.
No more waiting. The road south, then? Unless...
I know of another shortcut. You should be so lucky.
Appreciate your help with the Royalists' barricade earlier. We'll see you the rest.
Here cuts through Lorbert's Pass to Caer Norvan. You're not thinking of heading that way, are you?
If the Royalists were looking to take the Caer, they'd have posted sentries to prevent any unwelcome surprises. At least I would have.
Well, you should know. The Royalists thinking. Why take a stronghold they've no chance of holding?
When they've no intention of holding it, the King is up to something.
The King?
Well, you don't think they're acting on a whim, do you? This is one of His Majesty's cunning stunts. And he sent his best to execute it.
Thank you.
Even when it isn't crawling with royalists.
I don't care who else is in there.
You like that, don't you?
Much as I enjoy battering down the front door, I hazard this endeavor will require a bit more tact.
There's an old sluice that empties under the bridge. It should see us through to the lower levels of the Caer. Sid. We both know why I'm here. But what is it that you want? Why would you risk your life for a handful of outcasts? If anyone ever learned what you've been doing with their property...
They'd have my head in a box. But this isn't just about dominance and bearers, it's about all of us. What I want is to build a place where it doesn't matter what you are, but who you are. But our world isn't ready for a place like that. So, until it is, I use the power I've been given to show people there is hope.
So, tell me about this Benedicta.
The best and worst decision I ever made. Don't underestimate her, Clive. A fight with her icon is not one you're likely to walk away from.
Garuda. Warden of the Wind.
Hey.
Thank you. Thalan has fallen. The eastern territories all but belong to the orcs.
I'll have my men ready to depart by noon.
Don't bother.
But what of the mines? Without adamantite...
The Blight would have engulfed the mines ere long. Besides, you already have your orders.
Yes, my liege.
The dark swallows more of the realm with each passing day. The land starved of the aether that gives it life. And as the fringes fade, the people flock to the Mothercrystals, desperate for their blessing. The war we wage for possession of that blessing, it breaks us from within, hastening us to our own destruction.
And so you do what must be done.
I unite the dominance, that we may bring an end to the strife, and found a new order to see us unto tomorrow. The world must be restored, and I will see it so.
You might have already had Sidolphus not betrayed us.
Him again. Lust you still for his embrace?
But... of course not, my liege. I serve you, and you alone.
I remember well the day you first entered these halls. Your pale hand pressed into his, as if it would never let go.
That was a long time ago. Yours is the only hand I need. Now and always.
Soon, my dear. Soon all will know whose hand it is that keeps them from falling into the darkness.
Hold me, my liege. Never let me go.
One of our sentries has failed to report, m'lady. Your orders?
Pull the men back inside the Caer, Geralf.
He is here, then.
Have them lead Sid and his little pet to the chapel. I shall entertain them there. So you've come for me, after all.
Trick. You'll have to teach me sometime.
We should start with the dungeons. They may be holding the bearers there.
Sound plan. As long as we keep ourselves on this side of the bars.
In here.
You're gonna give up.
See this gate.
Need some help.
What do you think?
That I'm doing most of the lifting. Your leisure, Clive.
Did you hear that?
Unfortunately, yes.
Great sin may already be in the care. What?
Good news, lads.
You're searching out, man. This door only leads to more royalists. We'd better find another one.
Take your pick.
How about a window?
The Imperial garrison, right where the Royalists left.
Everywhere.
up, boy!
Just were you, Patrick? These poor sods didn't know what hit them.
The alarm.
All this bloody running. After them.
Traitor! Over here. There, boy!
plans for us. Little late for prayer, isn't it?
Do I seem so desperate as to grovel at the feet of a false god? I was waiting for you.
Not for too long, I hope. All this for a midnight chat. Well, let's chat then. Where are the men and women you took from Lost Wing?
You mean, where's the Dominant? Well, we shall be requiring his services indefinitely. Come back to me, Sidolphus. I need you. Think of all the things we can create together. The world that we can build.
You need me? Your king needs me. I'm all for building a new world. Just not his. That bastard's dreams are as twisted as his promises are false. And I want no part of them.
King Barnabas saved you, and this is how you speak of him. Have you no shred of loyalty?
What? To a leader who'd use me? Like he uses you.
You know nothing of me, Sidolphus.
You're right. I don't know who you are anymore. Or what you want. I only know what you used to say. That you were tired of running. That you just wanted to be free. Free of it all. You weren't lying to me then, so what changed? What made you think you had to sacrifice who you were to get what you wanted?
Sacrifice? I use my talents to my advantage, and you would tell me there is shame in that?
If there's no shame, then why do you feel so sorry for yourself?
A rousing speech, Lord Commander. I was a fool to believe you might have changed. The only person I feel sorry for is you! I can't do this anymore. If you would stand between our leash and his dream, then you leave me no choice. Goodbye, Sidolphus.
Stand back, Clive.
Finish them.
Well, Sid, the beast is not free against one. Sick of Torbjorn.
Yeah. Corvo. A little help! Get him! You know what to do. Don't let them get away.
She doesn't look happy, Torgal. Come on.
Sid, are you all right?
Do I look all right? Benedicta will be on her way to collect the Dominant, if she hasn't already. You can't afford to let them leave. Remember, she has wings, you don't.
What about you?
Before or after I catch my breath.
Sorry. Come on, Torgal. Be here somewhere.
Has been signaled.
An Imperium.
running out of tower.
Our lady wants us gone before sunrise.
Get him, Bob. Sick on Torvo. Keep your distance, boy. Get him, boy. Sick of Torvo.